Seeing the Earth as a round ball for the first time is really wild. You really get this sense how we're all in this together. Here on Earth, you know, we literally live on an island in our solar system. When you see that, you realize we don't have any other place to go. Physically, it's not really comfortable to be in space. It's hard to sleep. It's hard to go to the bathroom. You get this big fluid shift. Your body isn't loving this experience. I slept on the ceiling a couple times on my first flight. You know, some of the fun stuff we would do on the space station wasn't always the smartest thing, but you would have like this race, you know, from the mid deck of the space shuttle through the hatch. It's a little dangerous. You know, you split your head open. A few months before I was supposed to launch into space on my fourth flight, my wife, Gabby Giffords, congresswoman from Arizona, gets shot in the head by a guy trying to kill her from about 3 feet away, so she was in the hospital. And initially, I didn't think I'd be able to do the mission. A couple months later, I realized that it was important not only to me, but it would have been in the future important to her, and it was important to the crew and mission success that I actually tried to do this. So I was in space when she was in the hospital. And I was literally rendezvousing and docking with the International Space Station on day three of the mission while Gabby was getting her final brain surgery. It was a exercise in compartmentalization for me to be able to focus on this complicated task while I have this horrible personal negative thing going on in the background. You know going in that this is a sacrifice that you make. You've got this, you know, level of commitment that you just can't back out of. I am a big supporter of us sending people to Mars. I just don't want anybody to think that that's our escape hatch. It is not. I mean, you've got this whole idea of like Elon Musk saying, hey, we're all gonna move to Mars someday. We're not moving to Mars. The percentage of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere on Earth, less than 1%. And that's a significant problem. It's warming our planet. What do you think the percentage of carbon dioxide is on Mars in the atmosphere? 99%. Advancing, you know, our scientific knowledge of the universe is incredibly important. But I, you know, like I said, I don't think people should think that there's another planet we could move to someday. We'll be living on Earth. Because of that, we've got to do a better job taking care of it.